I do need to hide them.
In case someone wants to talk. It's more natural if they can hear me.
Thank you.
I'm going to turn the mic on now anyway, and we'll just record whatever we're saying. But yeah, the dogs were like, it was funny. They were snorting so much. Okay. Start coloring soon. Huh? I said I was going to start coloring this pretty soon.
What's the difference?
Right now I'm just doing the inking.
So what's the difference?
I'll show you.
Huh?
Come here and I'll show you. Camera's on, so you can stop there. So that's just the inking, right? All the black and white lines. And then, you know, see the little dwarf down here? You know, that's what it'll look like when it's colored.
Yeah, but I don't understand. I know the difference between inking and coloring. I don't understand what's the difference for Twitch.
No, there's no difference.
It's they like just... you informed me, like I'm going to do that, like it's something different.
Oh, yeah.
I'm going to do my macrame.
Okay, okay.
See you soon.
See you soon.
I'm not feeling well. I don't know why. Something is weird about me today.
So it never got better, huh?
It's like my headache wants to really burst, but it doesn't.
Did you take the migraine medicine?
Because I don't have daytime, it's only PM.
Mm-hmm. Thank you. Oh, my mic is on. Hey, Cap Doodles. Haven't seen you in a while. Hope everything's going good. How are you doing? Sorry it took me so long to see that you were here. Four a.m. huh? Yeah, I was thinking I might try this time zone, because when I was, you know, using the one where you saw me at first, like, honestly, no one comes by. For me, it's pretty darn quiet. So this is the first time I've done a stream at this time period. 4 a.m. What are you doing up so late, man? How's work? How's life? Too much coffee? Yeah, that does me in. If I have a lot of coffee, I can lay down, but I never really sleep. Just gets harder. Doing okay overall. I'm back on this guy. I haven't done anything on you know, Hellboy for a while, but I finally got him inked to a point where I think it's okay to put in the flats and, you know, do some more on it. Now it kind of gets interesting. I like inking. I like drawing and inking. But I think it gets more interesting when the colors start going down. And these are flats, so they're an indication of the direction the color's going, but they're not even close to being final stuff. Yeah, thanks very much. I'm pretty happy with it. I kind of like this guy. So I'll have to figure out what to do for a background. It's going to be something just swooshy. It's not going to be, it's not going to mean anything. Just more of some lines or something in the back. I'm not sure. But yeah, I'm pretty happy with it so far. A lot of this is, you know, when the colors start going on, my mistakes start getting hidden. So I'm okay with that. Yeah, it'll be something like that. It's something like, yes, exactly. I don't know exactly what, but that's a good way of explaining it. I'm going to coin that term. So how's work? This music is pretty random tonight. Yeah, it's work. But at least you're back to work. Now, maybe you didn't want to get back to work, but at least you're back. Making money. You did? All right, that's good. Good to hear. Forgive me for not remembering. I'm not quite sure we touched on this, but I know you're doing the restoration and stuff. Is that what you want to be doing, or do you want to be doing something else? I thought it was engineering. System engineering. System engineering, I forget, is that programming? Remember days you hold my hand, walk the streets, you and men. Did you know those days are gone? System. It was complex systems, right? That should be the last bot for another 15 minutes. Okay, that's right. I kind of remember that stuff. So, how's the market for that where you're at? Is that why you're not doing it right now? Because the market's tough to get into, or, you know, network servers and visualization? Okay. How much experience do you have doing the, you know, the IT stuff, the system engineering stuff? That's a lot of experience, and the market is awesome. All right, so I'm going to be kind of blunt. If the market is awesome and you have the experience and it's only about your CV, why haven't you fixed your CV and gone on out there? kind of ignore it. Just say you're doing independent consulting. It's really none of their business. I understand the challenge. I kind of face that challenge, but in a different way, just because I've been freelancing for so long. So a lot of people might say, you haven't been working, but you know, I have. And what's to stop you from putting that you've been an independent consultant for that time, just doing freelance stuff? I'm sorry to hear about your depression, by the way. I hope everything's better. Yeah, you could always get called on it here, and there's a lot of companies that'll do background checks, but there's a lot of companies that don't. And I'm not saying falsify anything, of course, but if you're recovered and you're better, I don't know. Is it their business what you did during those time, however long it was? I'm very relieved. Very glad you're back and healed. It's a good man. Yeah, okay. Very good to hear. I think medicine is not the way to go. So I'm glad you did on your own. You know, with help, I'm sure, but I'm glad it wasn't with meds. So, how do you think you can fix your CV? Because you're not the only person that has struggles in life. How do other people overcome their struggles? Yeah, as far as I know, I don't know anyone who's that close to the edge. But it's always sad to hear stories, man. Life can be hard. And it's always sad when people are losing hope, that much hope. Hey, and if the meds help them, it helps them. I mean, I'm not knocking it that bad, of course, but whatever helps is the right thing to do. Absolutely. No need to suffer if you have a way to not suffer. I mean, it sounds simple to say, but it's really important. I wish I had a magic answer. I always want to help people, but sometimes I just don't know. My situation can be very challenging over here too, and sometimes I feel like there's no fix. Nothing I can do. But I do know if you do nothing, you get nothing. And that keeps pushing me along. I hope you get the job you want. And soon, man. I'm not a religious man, but I'll be praying for you. I don't think you have to be religious to pray for people, so. Yeah, I'll be honest. This is honest. I'm kind of like, I don't know you, but I kind of feel like we're friends. So, and I want all my friends to have a good life. So, I will be praying for you. You know, I just wish everyone could have a good life. I think we'd all be so much better off if we can find some happiness. Well, you know, no matter what, unless one of us gets stupid, you know, you're my first Twitch friend. And nothing changes that. So, that by itself kind of puts you in a special spot for me. So, one thing I like about the internet is that you can make friends with people, and it's kind of easy. You know, a lot of judgment just is out the window. You don't have to worry about that crap. Sometimes all people need or want is just good communication. And that's the amazing thing. Missing some inking down here. Yes and no. All right, so tell me your point of view. Thank you. Yes, I absolutely agree. That's even super harsh. But yeah, if we're going to go down the cons of the internet, it has brought out the cowards, the hateful. You know, everything bad about people is found on the internet so easily. So, yep, totally agree there. So far, I've been lucky, haven't come across anyone hateful. Knock on wood. Playing a new game today. First group matching. One player didn't right away accept the invitation. What game? People wished him cancer. Yeah, that's ugly people. I think the problem is that people are who they're really going to be. So when there's a lot of hate on the internet, I think they're hateful. So I'm a little bit in disagreement with you there, that I think they truly are hateful, because it gives them an opportunity to say what they really want to say without repercussions. Would they be that way in real life? Probably not, right? Because, you know, the repercussion might be you get a punch in the face. But because they're basically free, it brings out the worst. The worst. Not everyone, of course, but yeah, there's a lot of ugly people. I've seen Monster Hunter on Twitch a little bit. That one looks pretty good. I haven't heard of Dauntless. I'm not a big gamer, but I haven't heard of it. I bet they have it on Twitch too, right? So I'll take a look at it. I wish I had time to play games, but no time at all for that. I always play Dungeons and Dragons. I'm old school. Get angry on the forums. Yeah, I think people, you know, the written word, like forums and stuff, because it's impersonal, I mean, to give people benefit of the doubt, sometimes it's just way too easy to take things the wrong way or take them more severe. So I have to be very careful. Like if I'm being sarcastic, I really make it clear that I'm being sarcastic. I'll put my sarcasm in quotes so that people understand that, you know, I'm not trying to piss you off. Feels good to just let out sometimes. Yeah. I think that's a weird way of letting it out, because now you're just forcing it on someone else. But that's just me. There's all types. Folks who can handle it and folks that have to yell. I get angry when I drive my car. And I almost considered, you know, responding to some stupid stuff online, but then I was like, you know what? I actually really don't care. I mean, I think everyone's entitled to opinions anyway. And it's sort of just a road to frustration. If you start responding, you know, you're not going to convince anyone to be different or anything like that. So it's kind of just bringing on frustration for yourself. So a lot of it I just ignore. Just not worth the time. Yep. But maybe the world will get tired of it. I kind of see, I've seen a lot of signs of people wanting to get back to just normal and chill and that kind of stuff. So you got people out there that I've seen on forums stuff that they really make it a, even here on Twitch, right? It's like, you know what? Let's chill. Let's relax. Let's have a good time. Let's enjoy each other's company. I see kind of a movement like that. So I don't know if it's true, but I kind of noticed something. So I'm kind of thinking people are fed up with the negative and they want to get back to something better. So we'll see. A couple years from now, we'll see if I'm right. Yeah, me too. You know, it usually goes that way. The pendulum swings one way, you know, for 20 years, and then it swings the other way for 20 years. So, hopefully. There's a lot of wonkiness out there still, though. A lot of surprising opinions. Hopefully things will chill out. So we'll see. That's why I like drawing. Because at least the artists that I've seen, you know, they're all pretty easygoing people. So I like the community I've been seeing. Some of the artists are super helpful too. Yeah, it is. I think, you know, the nice thing about art is no matter who you are, even if you're angry at the world, art is like meditation. You know, it's always relaxing. So no matter what's going on, you kind of have hope of just feeling good while you're drawing. Is art not relaxing for you? Yeah, I mean, I know exactly where you're coming from. But if you are going to pursue art and you do want to get better, the first thing you got to train yourself to understand is that it's going to be a long journey. And you got to try to enjoy the journey. Yeah. I promise you, every artist puts too much pressure on themselves, especially beginning artists. Because we compare ourselves to our heroes, right? Our art heroes. And we can never live up to that. You just can't live up to someone who's been mastering their craft for so long. And I don't always overcome that problem, but I've been trying a lot lately to realize, you know what? I just got to put my own pencil to paper and enjoy my time and just try to get better. Just try to get better. But being good at art, it's hard. It's a job. It takes dedication. I actually appreciate artists more now than ever before, because even the ones that I wouldn't say are great artists, I see where they're at, and I already know. It's like, okay, this person has put in, you know, 2, 4, 6 years of hard work to get where they're at, and they're still going on their journey, but they put in that time to get to where they're at. I didn't appreciate artists like that before. I only liked the best. But now I understand more. So I've kind of mellowed out. So my advice, not that you're asking for it, is practice with purpose. So don't just draw to draw. Pick something you want to be better at and draw just that for a little bit, you know, at least a couple days. Look online, look on classes, find out what you want. Like if you want to draw hands. If you want to draw hands better, just focus just on hands. And don't stop for like at least a week. And go in phases like that. That seems to work for me. I don't think I'm a wise man, but I appreciate the compliment. I think I've just been there. I've been there in the frustration, and then I had to, you know, have a conversation with myself. It's like, am I going to quit? You know, and I'm over 50, so I've let my harsh criticism of myself stop me from doing things most of my life. So I got to the point where I'm like, you know what? I can't do that. That's just wrong. And that's one of the reasons why I got on Twitch. You know, just say, you know what? Just dedicate yourself and enjoy the journey. Who knows how long you're going to have to do it, but just do it. So yeah, I've had a lifetime of holding myself back. I think people can be wise and not have to be there. But I appreciate the compliment, so thank you very much. I've had other people say I'm a wise person. So maybe all you guys know something I don't. Maybe you're onto something. No, I don't think it's the same either. I think wisdom is much more intuitive. I can buy into that. So yeah, I can't argue with that. I think I'm wiser now than I was when I was younger. You know, I can tell you I like this time frame more. Even though no one else is kind of jumping in the conversation, I don't blame them and all that kind of good stuff, but there's more visitors at this time frame than what I had before. So this might work out for me. I have Nightbot to set up every 15 minutes. Is that too much? I think I'll change that. I think it is too much. Oops, wait, what do I want? It's here, right? If I can remember where Nightbot is. It's not here, is it? Is it live actions? No. It's not this. So where is it? Save this first. I have, yeah, it does it. I have three messages. So they're three separate messages and they're set to go off every 15 minutes. But yeah, I've been meaning to change that for a while. I think it's too much. So I am going to fix it right now. I just got to remember, I think I got to go online to Nightbot. So, hold on just a sec. Let me do this. So I got more room to work. Yeah, it's just I was experimenting. Nightbot's new. Obviously, I didn't have it last time I saw you. I tried putting them all in one message, but it runs everything together. You know what I mean? So I couldn't do like three separate lines. It's all like one continuous line. So it just kind of comes out all gobbledygook. But I think it'll work if I change. Change the timing of it. So I'm on the dashboard right now. I gotta remember how to get back to it. I don't know if it's in commands. Timers. I think it's on timers. Oh, I actually have four of them. So Instagram, Facebook, YouTube, and Twitter, and they're all set up to go every 15 minutes. So yeah. Let's change those times. So Instagram, I'm going to do 30 minutes because that's the one I want everyone to follow. I like Instagram. I don't like any of the other things, or I like them less. Let's put it that way. So we'll do that for 30 minutes and everything else, we'll make it an hour. Thank you. So I think that's saved. Alright, that should help. No more Nightbot spam. So, I don't mind different music, but what do you think of this music? Does it drive you crazy? Or is it okay to mix it up? Yeah, they'll take over. Actually, we'll all convert and become robots, cyborgs. The best of both worlds. Yeah, I saw a, what's her name? Cloverkin? So she's on Twitch, artist of course, wears the elf ears. She recommended a website that had some sounds and music and stuff that was good for game players. You know, role playing, ambient music, that kind of stuff. And it sounded really cool because, you know, that's the genre I like, so I'm going to take a look at that and see if that's something that'll work. Most of the time, right now I'm using the music from this guy called TechnoAx on YouTube because he lets you use your music and doesn't claim any monetization rights or anything like that. And most of it's dubstep, but this playlist is not dubstep. This is a more eclectic mix, so I like it, but it's not for everyone, I'm sure. Yeah, so far no one has said anything about the music, good, bad, or indifferent, to be honest. But you know, I get a lot of people that come in here for just a couple seconds and then they zip right out. So I'm always curious on the analytics. Like, hey, why didn't you go? Is it subject matter? Is it skill? Is it music? You know, who knows? But you know, people are just bouncing around. Maybe they're just bouncing. More chill. It's kind of goofy in a good way. So it's whimsical. That's a better word for it. So it's kind of cool. The music tells a story. God. Thanks for telling me. Duh. Yeah. Thank you. I'm an idiot. That's pretty funny. But yeah, really, thanks for saying. Thanks. I've done that before, too. Not so long. This was actually the longest time I was just doing stuff and had the screen blanked out. But last time, I didn't have anyone watching. This time I do, so. Haha. That'd be funny if the screen was blanked out and then I started getting even more people coming in and stopping by and saying hi. Too much mystery, man. What are you doing? Well, you had to find out. Since the last time I saw you, I tried a couple different music options. But most of these free music options that I found anyway, they're fine to use on Twitch, so the live streams, it's not an issue. But I've been sending a lot of videos over to YouTube, and once I get to YouTube, you know, then the rights are claimed and they want to monetize the video. And I'm not quite sure if that means they take all the money or just a portion, because their songs are on a portion, but I've kind of avoided that. Yeah, stream the black screen. You know what? That could be we've just discovered our niche. We could do a dual stream, two black screens. People would go bonkers trying to figure out what we're talking about or what we're drawing. Then we'd be like, oh man, that's fantastic. That's such good art. You're doing really good. People are like, I want to see. And we could be two silhouettes, right? So the lighting set up in a way that they can't even see our faces. All they do is see the silhouettes. See, we're onto something. Now, I do not know why Nightbot said that. It's supposed to wait an hour. I'll fix that. Oh, I know, right? You have to be good. Otherwise, it's a big letdown. Everyone will be like, aw. And then they get angry. I wasted my time. But see, the secret is you never show them. If you're going to do a concept like that, you have to stick to your guns and never show them. Of course, it's not practical, but it's fun to think about it. Yeah, I know. Totally agree. Gotta deliver. Deliver something. Entertainment or good art or something. Gotta deliver. Before you came on, I had 8 people pop on and was watching me all at the same time. I didn't even realize it. No one said hello, so there wasn't much indication. I'm like, wow, 8 people all at the same time. So that was pretty cool. Yeah, I think it's good for an artist to be humble and let fans, if you have fans, decide, you know, if it's good or not. I think it's easy to be humble. Going back to sort of what we were talking about before, You know, our heroes are so damn good. How can you not be humble? Like for me, I think I'm finally at a place where I'm not horrible. I still have a long way to go, but I feel pretty good. I feel pretty good on where my art's been lately, this past year. Yeah, where you're the only one having a conversation and there's a bunch of lurkers. You know, I think I've been in some streams where not quite 200, right? But there's people and I would feel personally, I feel bad. They're having a conversation, they're kind of humming along, and yes, you can jump in and it would be totally okay, but you know, I let people have their conversation too. I don't really want to jump in on their conversation. Unless it's like general artsy stuff, stream stuff, you know, that kind of stuff. So yeah, just trying to be polite and give them their time. Yeah, if I got questions, I'll try to look for an opportunity to jump in without interrupting. Because, you know, on the other hand, if you got 200 people, so I'm going to back up. What I've been doing, what I've done before, is I might have a conversation going, and the room might be pretty quiet, and we're having a good conversation, and that's all good. But then people start coming, so I personally try to close out the conversation so that other people have the opportunity without interrupting to kind of jump on in. So I've had that just the other day. Yeah, I'm pretty good at lurking. Thank you. Yeah, topic matters. Sometimes I don't want to be part of a conversation because the topic is not so exciting. Like, I like real conversations when people are just sort of being goofy. I like to lurk. There might be something funny. But I'm kind of, I'll be honest, I'm kind of a one-track person. If I see an artist, usually my topics are like, hey man, what's, how long have you been doing it? What tools you're using? You know, that kind of stuff. Yeah, you better. Is it Saturday for you? I think it's Saturday, right? You're ahead of me. Checking the old world clock now. Yeah, me too. I always enjoy conversations. Yeah, zip right by. And I got a whole lot more work done because someone actually showed up and participated. So I appreciate that. Thank you for that. But yeah, look for me over the weekend if you want, if you get time. I'll probably do the same time frame tomorrow night. No promises, but maybe. I know that doesn't help you, staying up all night, but maybe I'll get some done in the morning. Who knows? I'll mix it up. But yeah, man, go get some sleep. Yep, yep, see you when I see ya. Break. So I'm going to mute the mic.
Thank you.